Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Here is the last story about the family of Abu Lahab. And it's about his wife, Ummu Jamil, Arwa bint Harb from Banu Umayyah. Once she heard about the revelation of this surah, Surah Al-Masad, she went around trying to look for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because her and her husband, you know, Abu Lahab, they never believed in the Quran. So they usually would say this is poetry made up by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there is one type of poetry when you attack someone, it's called in English satire. So this is why she said, oh, Muhammad is satirizing my husband and myself. You know what? Wallahi la'in ra'aytuhu la'alqimanna fahu hazal hajar. She got a stone or a rock in her hand. She said, if I were to see him, I'm going to hit him in his mouth with this stone. And she went running everywhere until she arrived at the Kaaba. And guess what? Who was sitting there next to the Kaaba? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and none other than the best man in this ummah after all the prophets. Man number one in the ummah of Islam, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. So he was sitting next to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and when Ummu Jamil arrived, she started talking to Abu Bakr. Guess what? Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu is sitting next to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's amazing that she's talking to Abu Bakr saying, Aina mudhammama? It's amazing that they wouldn't call the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam by his true name, because his name is very beautiful. You know, when you say Muhammad in Arabic, it means the one who is worthy of hamd. Hamd means thankfulness and gratitude and praise, because he is the embodiment of mercy to all humanity. So they replaced the name with mudhammam, which is the opposite. So this is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, was very cool. He used to say to the Sahaba, "Ala tarawna kayfa yasrifu Allahu anni sabba Quraysh wa shatmuha?" Don't you see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes away, you know, sabba Quraysh wa shatmuha, meaning like the swearing and the insulting of Quraysh against me? And they said, "How, Prophet of Allah?" He said, "Innahum yasubbuna mudhammama wa ana Muhammad." They're cursing someone and insulting someone called Mudhammam, but my name is Muhammad. Just be cool. When people try to make you angry or upset you, just be cool like the Prophet ﷺ. Because whatever they say about you is going to be in the record of bad deeds. And you will get their hasanat. So anyway, back to the story. The Prophet ﷺ is sitting next to Abu Bakr. And here is Ummu Jamil asking Abu Bakr, Aina Mudhammama? Meaning, where is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Where is the Prophet? And then Abu Bakr was amazed because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is sitting right next to him, and she should see both of them. And then he's looking at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she keeps saying, "Aina mudhammama?" Like, where is he? You know what? If I see him, I'm gonna hit him on his mouth with this rock because he's satirizing me and my husband. And then she walked away. And Abu Bakr was stunned. He looked at the Prophet ﷺ, he said, Prophet of Allah, she's asking about you and you're sitting next to me. He said, didn't you read in the Quran, Abu Bakr, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, once you start reciting the Quran, Allah makes a barrier between you and those who don't believe in the Quran? So when she came and I saw the evil in her eye, I started reciting the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took her eyesight. She couldn't see me. Isn't this amazing? And this is also another story that shows you how evil that woman was, how grudges, how malicious, and her husband were, and how they always acted in an arrogant, ignorant way towards the Prophet ﷺ. This is why they ended up losing in the dunya, and they will end up in company, but the worst company, in hellfire with a flame that she will keep increasing for herself and her husband. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from Jahannam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take us all to Jannah. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.